Hey, Jonathan here. So today we're going to take 5 minutes to understand how can we use a quick and dirty 3D model to start a CADing drawing. All right, so now let's go straight into Rhino. Let's see how we can profit from a 3D model and to make it a 2D model using the 3D model itself. You can either start with our file that you can download here. You can also start from a file from scratch and just do a box. All right, so in Rhino, to do this, we're going to use a command that's called a clipping plane. Then to make a vertical clipping plane, click on vertical. Then trace the rectangle in the perspective view. And then you can move it to edit your cut. And then you select the model and start the command that's called make2D. So it's a combination of these two commands that will allow us, that will tell Rhino, draw this for me. Select the model and start the command make2D. A window will appear where you should select the option front. Then we click OK. And somewhere around the zero, you should have the 2D lines. Once we have this, we're going to start tracing them to make them an actual drawing. So let's zoom in and start thinking about this a little bit. So for example, yes, I know what the project should be. These lines are already drawn, but if I'm drawing a section, what I want is definitely I need a terrain. The foundation should be under the terrain. So let's go ahead and put a very big window on the back building and then put a very big skylight on the little house. So now that we know what we want to do, what we want to achieve, it's the right moment to put on your headphones and start CAD junkying around. We're going to start assigning the pens. So assign the cut building to layer pen 0.20 and then assign the projected building lines to the layer pen 0.05. Then we're going to start adding new lines, for example, the earth line as the layer pen 0.35, which is the thickest one. So then we can use offset, for example, to cut the building to 0.2. You can also create the polylines of the door and the windows. Here, for example, he's using something called the nearest button or perpendicular snap. A scale is always very important to see more or less what size all these things have. Good. So now that we have the main drawing, let's move on to how do we get it out of the computer. So let's go over to the layout command. We type in layout and we select the size of the paper for A4 landscape. Then select the view and set the properties to 1 and 100. Sometimes it's tricky to make this work exactly as we just did it, but essentially you need to double click on the frame sometimes. After this, we should be ready to start the command print and save it. Now, I do understand that this is an oversimplification of CADing, but it gives you an impression of the point of view of my classes and how I'm always focusing on architects, designing architects, and how to take the most advantage out of this technology. And that's why I want to show you what can we use all these things for. In 3D Journey, you can find a full stock of videos to learn CADing in ArchiCAD, in Rhino, soon even in Revit. You can find the courses where you can learn the basic skills. I mean, like how to the CAD tools and then the modifier, and very simple and short videos supported by exercises which will give you practice in the steps it requires to create a 3D model. Now, the tutorials, you can apply the newly learned skills and develop a complete architectural rendering, a complete architectural drawing on your own pace. The goal is not only understanding how to draw with CAD, but also to learn the use of the most important tools for a clean and understandable drawing. More specifically, how to master the correct and essential tools to fully express an architectural idea. An extra thing to tell you what can we use this for, because that's the only real question we should ever have about technology and art. In case of 3D-based CADing, what I like about it is that we should be able to model something very quickly. We can then start generating different sections, a floor plan, two floor plans, a section, a perspective, completely automatic. Drawings are horrible. Drawings that say nothing, drawings that I could never show to a client, a professor, or a colleague. So when we talk about CADing at the end, it's all about line weight and what is it that we want to say. If we want to talk about the city, then we do this kind of plan. If we want to talk about the neighborhood, then we do this kinds of plan. If we want to talk about the position of the house in a hilly site, but at the end, it's always the same. It's the pen, the color of the pen, and where do I put the line? So remember, technology is here to help. Technology will not substitute your job unless you yourself make your job obsolete. Thank you very much, and I'll see you in the next one.